Now on to a terror attack in the U.S. We are 5 days away from the start of the trial of Army Major Nidal Hassan, accused of slaughtering 13 people and injuring more than 30 others in 2009. Now we're getting a direct communication from him to Fox News and you. Chief Intelligence Correspondent Catherine Herridge tells us what Hassan wants you to hear.
On the eve of his military trial, accused Fort Hood shooter Major Nidal Hassan released these handwritten and typed documents to Fox News, where he appears to renounce his U.S. citizenship, abandons his military oath as a commissioned officer, and explains his relationship with radical cleric Anwar al-Awlaki, the first American targeted for death by the CIA. Most of the documents include the acronym SOA, which is considered shorthand for Soldier of Allah. Hassan's business card, also bearing SOA, was found in his Texas apartment after the shooting. Hassan's attorney for civil matters, John Galligan, verified the authenticity of the documents and the signature, adding that the 42-year-old Army major, who is acting as his own attorney, directed him to provide the writings to Fox News. Quote, "He represented to me that he either personally wrote in longhand or typed the statements at issue. All of the documents were prepared by Major Nidal Hassan and were sent at his specific request to your network." Staff Sergeant Sean Manning, who was shot six times at the Fort Hood Readiness Center, first spoke to Fox News a year ago. With the Defense Department dealing with the attack in the context of, quote, workplace violence, Manning said via Skype the public should make its own assessment.
The government has tried to deny that this was an act of terrorism. I hope that if people hear the words from Hassan's own mouth that they'll understand that this was an act of terrorism.
In the only document bearing a date, October 18, 2012, he writes, quote, "I, Nidal Malik Hassan, am compelled to renounce any oaths of allegiances that require me to support, defend any man-made constitution like the Constitution of the United States over the commandments mandated in Islam. I therefore formally renounce my oath of office. This includes my oath of U.S. citizenship." In another handwritten document, he states, quote, "If I have made any mistakes, I ask for forgiveness and understanding." In the only typed document, Hassan declares American democracy and Sharia law are incompatible. Quote, "There is an inherent and irreconcilable conflict. In an American democracy, we the people govern according to what we the people think is right or wrong, even if it specifically goes against what Almighty God commands." Hassan also complains that America's ban on cruel and unusual punishment prevents the, quote, "flogging of a fornicator or severing the hand of a thief," which he says are punishments ordained by Allah. An expert in Islamic history and the Quran reviewed the documents.
So I think it's clearly an after-the-fact issue where he now is trying to put the sort of personal jihad that he involved in, trying to put it into a larger religious and sort of geopolitical context and justify what he's doing, perhaps in a sense to himself, but also, I think, in large measure to the folks in the Islamic world.
On his relationship with the radical cleric with whom he exchanged emails before the massacre, Hassan writes, quote, "He was my teacher, mentor, and friend. I hold him in high esteem. May Almighty Allah accept his martyrdom."
He's clearly saying that he's a homegrown extremist and he's somebody who identifies with Al-Qaeda's ideology. He's somebody who definitely reached out to an Al-Qaeda cleric and decided he was going to take up Al-Qaeda's cause here on American soil.
In court Wednesday, the military judge denied the use of three alleged emails between Hassan and al-Awlaki by the prosecution.
And the judge also declined to impose a gag order on Hassan. Fox News asked the public affairs officer at Fort Hood whether prosecutors wished to comment on Hassan's statements, and there was no immediate response, Brett.
Also, Catherine, what can you tell us about the military pay that Nidal Hassan is currently receiving?
Well, until his time after the arrest, Hassan has received somewhere close to $300,000 in military pay. And for the survivors, like Sean Manning, this is just disturbing and disgusting, given the fact that in these documents, Hassan appears to abandon his oath in the military as a commissioned officer.
Amazing. Catherine, thank you.
You're welcome.